morning, Beaver Nation. Welcome to our 2024 fifth grade recognition assembly. This morning, we're going to celebrate the personal academic growth of your fifth grade children. And we honor everybody here watching at home who sacrificed, smiled, laughed, and cried, contributing to the success of these fine young people. Real quick, some safety considerations. We got bathrooms out this hall, first door on the left going down that way. There's also the kid rooms out here if you wanted to use those for this event. We also have the emergency exit is out here to the right, out either one of these two doors, and then out the doors to the right in case we need to access that. I want to thank our awesome special educators, Ms. Styron, Ms. Gephardt. Where are they? There they are! Our instrumental music teacher, Ms. Dickin. Ms. Kinghorn back there. She's been working with the kids for years and years. Ms. Sloan. Ms. Steinmiller, our intervention crew, it took a whole team of people to bring our children to this place. Ms. Dotton, our psychologist. Ms. DeBeek, our counselor back there, thank you. Ms. Wagers, our GT teacher. Yep, Ms. Lewis, our instructional coach, our special area team, and the whole thing back there. What show's not working? Seems to be on. All right, we'll cross that bridge in a minute. All right, so please, we already welcomed the class of 2024. Let's give them another big round of applause. Please. All right, right now we want to welcome Ms. Catalina Wilhoit up to the stand to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Specialist, Mrs. Marilyn Johnson, who's going to introduce some selected fifth graders who are going to read us of their letters.
Good morning and welcome, families. You look wonderful. Welcome to our teachers and staff, and welcome to our esteemed fifth grade scholars. I am Marilyn Johnson, the community school specialist. And we know, as our students learn from second grade, a community is a place where people live, work, and grow. And they build relationships that last a lifetime. Fifth graders were asked to write letters to Riverside, speaking about what the Riverside community means to them. And I have the honor of introducing the three that were selected. Please welcome Mason Miracle. Dominic Ordinato. And welcome Ms. Michaela Mack.
My name is Mason Miracle. I came to Riverside Elementary School in 2018, and it has been a wonderful experience. I'm sad we are leaving, and I hope we can all revisit the school in the future. I'd like to start off by saying thank you to all the teachers and staff here for everything you have done to help us on our educational journey. Although our time here is ending, we look forward to starting the next chapter. There will be a lot of fun. There were a lot of fun activities in our fifth grade year that we were able to participate in. Some of these events include tie-dye, shirt day, field day, picnic lunch, Parker Glenn, the Orioles game, the ice cream social, and our trip to Washington, D.C. All these events would not have been possible if it were not for the dedicated teachers and staff that helped organize them. We would like to say thank you for all that you've done and continue to do to make our last year here at Riverside so special. During our time at Riverside, I've met a lot of great people. The relationships that I have made here will continue to our next school and long after that. I'd like to say thank you to all our teachers, Mr. Hamilton, Ms. Sample, especially some of my favorites like Mr. Berg, Ms. Berg, Ms. Kinghorn, Mr. Torres, and my current teacher, Mr. John. They have all helped me on my journey to middle school. I'm so thankful for all the lessons and opportunities I have had on my journey here. We were able to get through some tough days like our MCAP testing because our teachers helped us to prepare us for it, just like they have helped us prepare for middle school. Now we are here, about to leave forever, and I am nothing but thankful for everything that has happened here and on my journey through this school. We have truly learned what it means to be respectful, engaged, and safe students. And that is a lesson you'll never forget. Sincerely, Mason.
Dear Riverside, you have been providing me with constant intelligence and teachers who care about me and my education, like my fifth grade. Dear Riverside, you have been providing me with constant intelligence and teachers who care about me and my education, like my fifth grade teacher, Ms. Hawkins, who did the Potato Olympics, which was incredibly fun. During my years at Riverside, I have learned countless skills and life lessons that may aid me in the following years to come. They taught me how to do long division and multiply fractions. I also learned how to play the violin and the ukulele. Some of those lessons come with incredibly special memories, like when they squirted all of the fifth graders with water on field day. I will remember Riverside even after I go old, weary, and 90-something years old. I will still remember Riverside as the school that prepared me for middle school and got me next grade ready. Thank you so much, Riverside.
Riverside is an amazing school, and the teachers, staff, and students work so hard to make this school a great community. They have taught me how to be a great person and how to be respectful to others no matter what. Riverside is a school that never judges you unless you be yourself. Riverside supports you no matter what. Riverside is a school that believes in you and gives you more chances when you mess up. And the amazing teachers at Riverside help me push through all the challenging times and makes me feel loved. This quote describes all the amazing teachers at Riverside that makes me happy to come to school and make fun learning. Shout out to Ms. Ware. A good teacher can inspire hope, ignite the imagination, and instill love for learning. Brad Henry. On the first day of school, I was nervous, but then I felt comfortable after being welcomed by Ms. Sample and Mr. Hamilton. Although I was nervous about the first day, I was excited about Ms. Ware being my new teacher and seeing my friends. As I walked into my new classroom, I was greeted by my wonderful teacher. She gave me a big warm hug, and it felt like sitting in front of a fireplace during winter. For the rest of the year, Ms. Ware taught me how to be who I am now. Here's an inspiring quote from Ms. Ware that has helped me and other scholars this year stay in place. Watch your words, because your words become your actions become your character, and your character is who you are, Ms. Ware. In conclusion, Riverside is not so perfect, but that does not matter. What matters is that we show respect towards others and treat each other with kindness. This journey at Riverside Elementary has taught me and other scholars how to be ready for sixth grade. I'm so grateful for my friends and teachers. Shout out to Kylie and Kat for always being there, and Ms. Ware. Being in Ms. Ware's class boosted my confidence like a flying bird. It taught me to always work hard. Riverside Elementary means a lot to me and changed me a lot. Sincerely, McKay.
Future is bright, isn't it? So that's just an example of some of the excellent work that these students have done. Let's give them all another round of applause. Thank you, Dominique. over to Mr. Hamilton.
All right. Okay, families, we're about to call each child up in alphabetical order, one at a time, beginning with Ms. Ware's class. Each child, so just so parents, so you know, this is how we set up for this, all right? Each child's gonna pause after receiving their certificate right here, right at the center of the stage, right there, so you can get perfect picture. Balloons and everything right there. The little stop sign like right there. Shoot from there, they do their little clap, and they can wave at Beaver Nation on their way out the stage. We are having some problems with our live link right now. For some reason, it's not working, but I'm going to upload this as soon as the ceremony is done. Alrighty. Please be courteous, take your picture quickly, and then bail because someone's coming right behind him. We've got 90 kids to go through. Alright. Alright, so Mrs. Ware, you're up.
Fifth grade scholars, but there's a special place in my heart for my fifth grade class and my third grade babies that are now going on. Mrs. Ware's scholars, please stand. You may leave your folders at your seat. We're learning from our mistakes. Miss Chloe Atwood. Cameron Barnes. Segment. Riddick Simmons.
This year, I know we've had some bumps along the way, but you guys have adapted, you've changed, you've grown, and I'm so, so proud of you. Thank you, parents, for all of your support this year. It's been a great year. Give yourselves a round of applause. All right, my class, go ahead and stand up, please. Dominic Adornado. Jaden Anderson. Aubrey Brooks. Karina Chase. Hazel Claycomb. Kaylee Douglas. Bailey Delaney. Jackson Earhart. Zeta Gill. Elon Hang. Carter Hicks. Yes, Carter! Peyton Jackson. Celine John. Zayden Johnson. Zavion Johnson. Lakeland Kessner. Vincent La Martina. Sorry, Daniel Martin. Ayatomi Ojo. Drake Shannon.
Come back with the
Jeremiah Stark. Chiatoka Mazzi. Vincent Wonga. And last but not least, Amina Yakin. Thank you all so much. I would like to welcome Mr. John Sollon.
Good morning, Riverside families. How are we doing today?
Get a little I know, it's a little
there you go.
It has been a year, or for me, a half year. We've had some trials and tribulations to work through. One thing I do want to give all my scholars a huge amount of props, because they have faced a couple different teachers this year, including me. It was a little bit rough to start, but I think we made our way through it, and we've really bonded. They have taught me just as much, if not more, than I have taught them, and I am incredibly proud to be able to be up here with them at their graduation. Mr. Jobs class, please stand. Anaya Abramson. Emerson Bodiger. Aubrey Cornell. Giovanni Catania. Cohen DeBoard. Navion DeShield. Malik Drummond Jr. Cameron Fisher. Malik Floyd.
You did it, man.
Antonio Furtado. Natalia Housley. Jackson Houston.
You got this, man.
Tyler Jones. Savannah Kelball. Lanice King. McKenna Mack. Mason Miracle. Noah Pimentel. No. Azaria Scott. Emmeline Sears. Tori Thompson. Jayla Webb. Makai Wilkes. And last and certainly not least, Noah Williams. Give it up for our fifth grade scholars, please. All right, next up, I would like to introduce a woman who is strong and passionate and as caring as I've ever seen. Our Harford County Assistant Principal of the Year, Mrs. Sample.
Thank you. That was not in the script, but I do appreciate the reminder. Alrighty, so we're going to honor the students who earn, I gotta get this mic situation straight. We're gonna honor our fourth quarter academic award. So students, like we practiced yesterday, we're going to do honor roll first, then distinguished honor roll, and you're just gonna stand in your seat, okay? You don't need to come to the stage for that. Remember, if I mispronounce your name, just respectfully tell me how to say it correctly. Okay, I will do my best. Ms. Hammer, you ready? Yeah. All right, starting with Ms. Hawkins' class. Remember, please stand where you are. These are students with A's and B's for the first quarter. Dominic Adornado. Aubrey Brooks. Kaylee Douglas. Zayden Johnson. Lakeland Kessner. Chia Coca. Where's my Chia? Where's Chia? In beautiful gym. Chia Coca. Mazzy. Did I get that? Alrighty. And that is Ms. Hawkins' class. Let's give them another round of applause. Mr. Sollon's class, honor roll, please stand and call your name. Aubrey Carnell. Bowen DeBoer. As we call him, Malik Double E Drummond Jr. Noah Pimentel. Azaria Scott. And Jayla Ware. Here we go. Ms. Ware's class, A's and B's for the fourth quarter. Cameron Barnes. Paige Bosley. Dustin Henderson. Chase Johnson. Caleb Kutza. Alina Lorenzo. Jordan Love. Michaela Mack. Charles Sigmund. Titus Terrell.
Should I get that one?
another round of applause for our honor roll recipient. Alrighty, so now we're doing distinguished, and this is for students who earned straight A's for the fourth quarter. Please stand when your name is called. Karina Chase. Hazel Claycomb. Jackson Earhart. Jackson Earhart. Thank you. Elon Hay. Peyton Jackson. Daniel Martin. Vincent LaMartina. And Tony Ojo. Alrighty, straight A's for Mr. Solon's class. Where am I from? Emerson Bodiger. Your assistant principal is a work in progress. He's my unofficial son, Mason Miracle. He doesn't even know this yet. Come on, he's just my unofficial son. You don't know that. And then Tori Thompson. Ware's class, straight A's. Maya Kai. Sophia Fernandez. Audrey Rodriguez Moran. Padaya Tata. Kylie Tinsley. Let's give our straight A recipients a round of applause. All right, so we talked about yesterday, friends. All right. So yesterday we talked about two special awards. One of them, do you remember what they were? Who were they? Just shout them out. We're here.
Mr. John, and
perfect attendance. The presidentials are coming. So those of you who've been in the Riverside community for a while know about Mr. John. Raise your hand if you remember Mr. John. He was a lifelong custodian for Riverside, and he passed away my first year here at Riverside. And because he was just such a great, caring, kindful, committed veteran of the Army, that we wanted to make sure that, you know, when we're in this building, there's something to remind us of him. So we did a couple things. We had a parade for him. And if you're ever in the building near the nurse's office, near Commons 1, his shirt, his custodial shirt, is hanging in a shadow box. But we also wanted to make sure that year after year, we're keeping his memory alive. So we established the Mr. John Award. Okay? And this goes to a fifth grade student, and it's presented as the one who constantly demonstrates leadership, and I call it quiet leadership. Okay? I am a behind the scenes quiet leader. Some of my people won't agree with that, but I am. And this person, you wouldn't probably, when you see him, think is a leader, but he is. And he does it quietly, he does it respectfully, and he just minds his business. So the recipient of the Mr. John Award for this year is Jackson Houston. Come on up, Jackson. Fifth grade, it's been a pleasure serving as your assistant principal. As you move on to middle school, know that you can do hard things and that you can do all things. You guys are intelligent. You guys can do anything that you put your mind to. And I've seen it happen when I visited your classroom. And where's Paige? I remember the day I saw Paige in class, and she was working through a challenging problem. And she was working that brain muscle. I could see that you were engaged in your learning. Don't ever lose that. Remember, once a beaver, always a beaver, and come back and see us from time to time. We love to see you guys, okay? Alrighty, so prior to COVID, we used to celebrate perfect attendance. And then we stopped because we were in a pandemic. But we're getting back to the practice of recognizing students with perfect attendance because we do want to acknowledge our students who come. And this year, we had three friends who came to school every day. I don't think we've had that in a really long time. I don't even have perfect attendance. So I just thought it was worthy to recognize these individuals, and we will be including it in our ceremonies moving forward. I do want you to come to the stage. First individual, Cameron Bishop. Next individual. Next individual, Elon Hang. Give them a big round of applause. All right, you may now exit the stage. I'm going to turn this back over to Lee Beaver, Mr. Hamilton.
Thank you, Mrs. Sample. One more round of applause for Mrs. Sample. All right, next up are the Presidential Achievement Awards. I'm going to read one letter. Yep, and then the kids are gonna come up and we're gonna line them up. Now they're gonna need a lot of space here. We're gonna do silver. All right, here we go. All right, so this is from the White House. Jill and I are happy to join your family, friends, and teachers in congratulating you for earning the 2024 President's Education Award. This year you showed your curiosity, persistence, and determination to succeed. I hope you are proud of all you've achieved. I often say that we are at an inflection point in history, a moment where we will answer the questions that define our nation's future. Who are we? What do we stand for? What do we believe? Who will we be? And I've never been more optimistic about our future because your generation, the most talented, tolerant, and generous generation in American history, will help us answer those questions. I look forward to seeing the great things you will accomplish in the years ahead. Whatever path you choose, I hope you will keep working hard, keep believing in yourself, and keep remembering that there is nothing you cannot do. Please accept my best wishes for a future filled with happiness and success. That's the president. There you go. All right, Ms. Hawkins, Silver Educational Achievement Awards. Lakeland Kessner and Davion Johnson. Sollon's Educational Achievement Silver Awards, Cameron Fisher, Jackson Houston, and Tori Thompson. Educational Achievement Silver Awards, Chloe Ackwood, Emmanuel Robertson, Charlie Sigmund, and Aaliyah Stockman. Yeah, our Silver Academic Award winners. Time for the goals. These are all A's and B's, 2 years in a row, as well as performance on the state test, MCAT. So this is here we go. This is our Gold Presidential Excellence Award, Ms. Hawkins class. Dominic Arenado, Aubrey Brooks, Serena Chase, Hazel Claycomb, Jackson Earhart, Elon Harmon Hang, Peyton Jackson, Vincent LaMartina, Daniel Arden, Ayatomi Ojo, Vincent Wanda. Let's bring it, Ms. Hawkins class. Mr. Sollon's Presidential Award for Excellence. Emerson Bodiger. Natalia Housley. Mason Miracle. And Azarius Scott. Mrs. Ware, and plus a Ms. Hawkins student that she was here in third grade. That's gonna help. Amina Yakin, get up here. All right. The rest of Mrs. Ware's Gold Medal Excellence Presidential Awards for Academic Excellence. Paige Bosley. Maya Cobb. Sophia Fernandez. Chase Johnson. Kayla Kupta, Alina Lorenzo, Michaela Mack, Audrey Rodriguez Moran, Titus Will, Padaya Teta, and Kylie Tinsley. We got another one? Catalina Wilhoit. I got a couple of closing remarks, and then we're going to close out with a special treat for you all. Yeah, you guys ready? All right, well, you get to settle yourselves in. All right, here we go. This year, all year, together, we've worked to help make your child next grade ready. Everyone in this room understands just how much growth academically, physically, and socially that truly entails. We've been in this together through significant challenges and obstacles, many of which were unexpected, but all of which were met with love in our hearts and victory in our mind's eye. It took a team, it took a village, families and teachers, counselors and special educators, support staff, friends, all the teachers before this year's to bring these scholars to the point that they are at now when they're prepared to leave us. Today, we're only turning the page. The middle school chapter lies ahead, and those pages will be filled with fun, with struggle, with challenge, and with significant growth. Believe in one another, believe in yourselves, and together you will all continue to grow, learn, and work for the betterment of this nation that you call home. On one final note, your sixth grade scholars now learned over the course of this year to advocate and elicit change in their world, and in that spirit, they got to choose their walking out song. An expurgated version. You want your special treat first?
Yeah, what the
end? Special treat first, says Chase. So here we go. Special treat time. Mrs. Ware, where are you? You ready to lead it? Engage. All righty. We're setting it up. Fifth graders, levántense.
see if you turn on Sasha Fierce, but I want to see something to celebrate everything you come out. Now, you be careful with your shoes, okay? But you chose the song, and we want you to march out with that energy. Teacher, I want to see a step from you, too. Let's turn it up. You ready? Let's hop with the hit.
Oh, boy. Yeah.
I don't know.